of all, 1.5 pounds of meat for 6 people.
Cut up into cubes, obviously. And that's very lean meat, too.
That's right.
Very lean.
I've trimmed off any excess fat, but in fact there wasn't.
Then you're doing your usual trick of flouring everything so well.
An ounce of flour. Into there. Shake it about and then fry it in dripping.
Bacon dripping, which you've saved from your bacon. All very good. I must say that obviously adds flavour too, the fact
it is
the bacon fat.
In goes the melted fat, 1.5 pounds of meat.
That doesn't take very long, in fact, does it, to get it all coated? And that seals the juices in, presumably.
That's right.
Yeah.
You can hear it beginning to spit. There we are. I'll just seal the juices. And while that's frying, I'm going to just take the skins off the tomatoes.
Now, that's again something, yet another of your tricks. You make it all seem so easy, and they come out in their whole like that with their skins off.
Now, they're a good buy at the moment. If you buy the cooking tomatoes, they're that much extra cheaper.
Now, strangely enough, in London, I understand they're about 25.5 pence a pound. The national average is 28. I'm full of these facts today. And, of course, the cooking ones, as you say, are cheaper than that.
That's right.
And what are you doing? You're putting them in boiling?
In boiling water, just enough to cover them like that. Turning them over, and then you'll be able to peel the skins off quite easily. But they're a bit mushy because they're the cheaper tomatoes, so I shan't leave them in for many moments.
What about a minute, a couple of minutes?
Oh, it's very difficult, Judith, to give a time because it depends on how mushy the tomatoes are. Don't tie me down, people might ruin their tomatoes. Then peel the tomatoes off. It comes off very, very easily.
And someone else was telling me today that you can actually as well just stick them on a fork and hold them over a gas flame.
That's right.
And the skin will just come off very easily too.
Comes off very simply. If you're doing a lot of them, you should put them in a bowl of cold water, having taken them out, because you'll find that they burn your fingers. There we are. Just wipe my hands, Judith.
It's beginning to brown now, isn't it?
Yes, there we are. Now, as it's beginning to brown, I'm going to add the onion to it. Can I give you that? Also clears my table. Now, the tomatoes want cutting up. You can feel they're a bit squashy and soft. I'm only going to quarter them. And I'm only putting 1/4 pint of stock in this recipe. Because there's an awful lot of moisture in the tomatoes.
Your stock being...
Well, because I haven't made stock from a chicken bones or anything, and I'm using just a stock cube and 1/4 pint of water. There we are.
Shall I stir that meat round or not?
Yes. Okay. There we are. Now I'm going to put it into the dish, Judith. It could fry for a little bit longer, but that's just seal the juices, which is what matters. So put all the fried meat into the casserole. It's a lovely smell, isn't it?
Gorgeous.
Now the 1.5 pounds of meat I'm now making do 6 people. There were days when I used to say it did 4 people, but this is certainly going to 6. Then put the tomatoes on top. And they're really soft and mushy, and they're being dark red, they'll give a lovely colour to the casserole.
As well as, of course, a lovely added flavour.
And putting the meat at the bottom, because the intense heat will be at the bottom. And then to the other seasonings, a little Leon Perrin sauce, about 1 tablespoonful.
That's the Worcester sauce.
Worcester sauce,
And a soy sauce.
And soya sauce. Chinese soya sauce. 1 tablespoonful.
And that'll all work itself around, won't it?
And also, I'm going to put some red currant jelly because sometimes the acidity of the tomato is a bit sharp. And so, red currant jelly. Now, a tablespoonful. There we are. If you haven't got red currant jelly, don't go and buy it specially. I would use another jam, a dark red one.
Can you do that with turkey, as a matter of interest? Because you know you have... it's lamb, of course, you serve red currant jelly with.
Yes, that's right.
Because I didn't have any yesterday and I didn't know whether
the
I could have...
turkey red currant jelly goes jolly well when you think you have cranberry sauce, don't you,
yes.
Normally?
Yeah, but I didn't have either yesterday, you see, so I was in shtuck and I wondered if there was any other jam I could have used, perhaps. Can you use black cherry jam or anything?
Would
like?
Be delicious, but a bit expensive.
Yes.
And a quarter of a pint of stock over the top.
Mm.
Now, that's making a really light, summery tomato casserole when beef is such a good buy at the moment. So I'm going to put that into the oven and I'm going to bake it for until it's tender about 2 hours at 325, gas number 3.
So it's a nice long slow sort of cooking process, right. Mary, really, isn't it? On number 3.
And here's one that's ready. Can I ask you to shut the door, Judith?
Of course, yeah.
Nothing if not hot. Looks beautiful,
that
doesn't it?
That is delicious. Yes.
There we are.
Gosh, that smells.
Now you see how liquid it has become because of the tomatoes. Mm. And you must skin the tomatoes, otherwise it would be absolutely horrid.
Mm.
But there we are, into the dish.
That's very good.
And new potatoes should be getting cheaper. So I'm going to add some new potatoes.
Which you've got over here.
Yes. Now, Judith, you could, if you wish, have it with noodles. They would go rather well. But I've got just new potatoes that have had a little butter added.
You've obviously done those in a blender thing because they're very smooth.
Yes.
Yes.
I did them in a, you know, one of those whizzes that you do it quickly because I like little potatoes and they're much nicer when you take off every bit of peel. There we are. One potato that dropped out in front. And then we'll put that over there where it's not hot.
Mm.
And then, Judith, to add a bit of colour, some chopped dill on top of the potatoes.
Have you got all herbs in your herb garden?
No, I've only got the ones that I like. And dill is grown as an annual, you grow it from seed, and it just makes new potatoes so nice. And you can mix a little bit of chopped mint with it if you prefer. And you see how feathery and light that looks.
Yes, that looks very pretty, doesn't it?